The National Development Plan 3 is the third in a series of six development plans whose primary goal is to increase average household incomes and improve the quality of life of Ugandans from 2020 to 2026. But findings of a review conducted by the National Planning Authority paint a grim picture, especially around poverty levels. According to the report, poverty levels have stagnated at 21%, accompanied by lower growth. Youth leaders blame this on the slow implementation of the NDP 3. These want the government to fully implement the NDP 3 recommendations, especially on youth empowerment and economic transformation, believing this is the only way to fight the widespread poverty in the country.
Realizing that the NDP 3 is a well-detailed, good program to deliver this country into the middle-class income, but the practices and the implementation modalities of this plan at different levels, be it at the district, at the national level, they are different and are not propelling development as the plan speaks. So you realize that when it talks about education, yes, it talks about skilling young people, educating them, but also when you zero down to the practice and implementation, you realize that schools don't have scholastic materials, don't have facilitation enough, especially the UPE, the USE schools. They are not well facilitated. They lack a lot of pedagogical requirements to ensure that they deliver as per NDP3.
Because we now want education system where someone is given skills so that he or she comes out to employ him or herself. Then someone going to school and comes back to search for white collar jobs. So if the 50% of the children are targeted well, we can be able to achieve the seven pillars of the Paris Development Model and also the NDP 3 goal of 2026, we can be able to achieve it as a country. But the biggest challenge remains the issue of sensitization, because the mindset of the society remains rigid.
Meanwhile, Judith Mutabazi, the head of population and social planning in the National Planning Authority, said they are already putting in place several strategies to counter the widespread unemployment and other economic challenges. Mutabazi further revealed that COVID-19 pandemic greatly affected the implementation of the NDP3. However, they are working out modalities to ensure that the document is fully implemented.
We are really trying to see how do we catch up with those targets that we haven't met, that they're still under performance, and more in all, we're seeing increased cases of youth unemployment. How do we deal with that? But overall, there's national high unemployment rate. How do we deal with that?
Rachel Nashuala reporting for the news.